The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 22, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 26th of November, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Dijinnani jatha vihaya namani ginnati nara aparani तथा शरीराणि विहाय जिन्नानि अन्नानि संजाति नमानि देही. So this verse we discussed last morning, that this body is just like dress. This is not our real identification. I'm thinking I'm American, I'm Indian, I'm African, I'm Russian, I'm Brahman, I'm Kshatriya, I'm Shudra, I'm Andhra Pradesh, I'm Bengali. These are all nonsense. But on this nonsense idea, the whole world is going on. So how there can be real knowledge? The basic principle of knowledge is ignorance. Andha. The man who is leading, he is blind. So how he can lead? This is the position. Andha jatha andhai rupaniyamana steti satantra urudami vadhya. They are trying to make advancement of civilization, but the basic principle is wrong. They are accepting, this is called illusion, accepting something as something else. Just like this. If I identify myself with this coat and shirt, the basic principle of my identification is lost. So here it is clearly said that vasaṁsi cinnāni. Before this, vidā vināsinam nityam jāyinam ajamam vayam kathaṁsa purusa prātha kaṁ ghātayeti hantikam. Anyone who knows that the living entity, soul, is avināsī, indestructible, then where is the question of killing? But that does not mean the Bhagavad Gita is encouraging killing. No, that is not the purpose. Killing is prohibited, but when we see that a brahmana is killing one animal in the sacrifice, it is not killing. Therefore we have to see with the eyes of Vedic knowledge, not with these eyes. What is the value of these eyes? It has no value. We are very much proud. Can you show me? Hey, what is value of your seeing? Even if I show you, the value of your seeing power is nil. It sees only under certain conditions, that's all. If there is light, you can see. So what is the value of your eyes? Therefore, the real seeing is through Vedic knowledge. That is seeing. Sastra chakushya. Real knowledge, real seeing power should be through the Shastra. And Shastra means infallible, not theory. Not theory, just like a conditioned soul writes some book on some thesis. So what is the value of it? It has no value. Because the man who is putting forward the thesis, he is blind, he is imperfect. So how can get perfect knowledge from it? So our proposition is that to receive knowledge from Krishna, the perfect person, the Supreme Personality of God, we accept Shastra means which is infallible. There is no mistake. Just like when I was walking near the cow shed, heaps of piles of cow dung was there. So I was explaining to my father that if animal, I mean to say man's stool was heaped up here, nobody would come here. Nobody would come here. But the cow dung, there are so much heaps of cow dung still, we find it pleasure to go through it. And in the Vedas, it is said, cow dung is pure. This is called Shastra. If you argue, how it can, it is an animal stool. But the Vedas, because the knowledge is perfect, that even in argument, we cannot prove how animal stool becomes pure, but it is pure. Therefore, Vedic knowledge is perfect. And if we take knowledge from the Vedas, we save so much time for investigating, for researching. We are very much fond of research. And everything is there in the Vedas. Why do you waste your time? So this is Vedic knowledge. Vedic knowledge means which is spoken by the Supreme Lord, that is Vedic knowledge. Or Paurasya. It is not spoken by common man like me. So if we accept Vedic knowledge, if we accept the fact as it is stated by Krishna or his representative, because his representative will not speak anything which Krishna does not speak. Therefore he is represented. The Krishna conscious persons are representative of Krishna because a Krishna conscious person will not speak anything nonsense beyond the speaking of Krishna. That is the difference. Other nonsense rascals will speak beyond Krishna. Krishna says, Manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji magnanus namaskuru. By the rascal scholar will say, no, it is not to Krishna, it is something else. Where do you get this? Krishna directly says, Manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji magnanamaskuru. So why do you deviate? Why do you say it is something else? It is something within Krishna. You'll find, I don't wish to name, there are so many rascal scholars, they interpret like that. Therefore, in spite of Bhagavad Gita being a book of knowledge of India, so many people are misguided due to these rascal scholars, so-called scholars, because they simply misinterpret. Therefore, we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. Krishna says, sarva dharmān parityajya māṁ ekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja. We say, we are preaching this kind. Be Krishna conscious. Just become a devotee of Krishna. Offer your respect. You have to offer your respect to anyone. You are not supreme. You have to flatter somebody to get some service. That is an, even if you get nice position, you have to flatter. Even if you get a president, become president of the country, you have to flatter your countrymen. Please give me vote. Please, I shall give you so many facilities. So you have to flatter. That is a fact. You may be very big man, but you have to flatter somebody. You have to accept some master. Why not accept Krishna, the supreme master? Where is the difficulty? No, I shall accept thousands of masters except Krishna. This is our philosophy. I shall accept thousands of teachers except Krishna. This is my determination. And then how you can be happy? Their happiness can be achieved only by accepting Krishna. Bhoktaram jagratapasam sarvalokamaheshwaram sridam sarvabhutanam jnatamam shanti michyat. This is the process of shanti. Krishna said that you accept that I am the enjoyer. You are not enjoyer. You are not enjoyer. You may be president or you may be secretary, you may be whatever you may be, but you are not enjoyer. Enjoyer is Krishna. One should know it. Just like in your I have coming, just replying one letter from the Andhra Relief Committee. So what this Relief Committee will do if Krishna is not satisfied? Simply by raising some funds? No, that is not possible. Now there is raining. Now you'll get benefit. But that raining depends on Krishna, not on your fundraising capacity. That is yajna. Yajnat bhavati parjanna. So yajnat bhavati parjanna. If you perform yajna, then there will be regular rainfall. If you avoid yajna, there will be restriction. And what your plan and fundraising capacity will help. Now there is sankirtan yajna and rain is falling. This is a fact. So if you continue performing yajna, then there will be no distress, no unhappiness. That is the plan. Just like the birds and bees, they have no problem. Because they are less than human being, they are working according to the prakriti's, nature's ways of life. So their foodstuff is ample. Their foodstuff is ample. So the yajnat bhavati parjanna, parjanyat anna sambhava. If there is no rain, how you can produce food? And this, and the rain is possible when there is yajna. This is described in the Bhagavad Gita, that when there was creation, it was the advice of Brahma to perform yajna. So we have given up all kinds of yajna. Although performing yajna at the present moment is very difficult because we cannot get pure ghee. The yajnas or the sacrifices mentioned in the Vedas, he requires tons of ghee, but that is not possible to obtain at the present moment. But there is another yajna. Yajnai sankirtanai prayai jajantihi sumerasa. There is another yajna recommended in this Kali Yuga. Krishna Varnam Tisa Krishna Sangha Pangatu Parsadam Jagai Sankirtanai Prayai Jajantihi Sumerasa. In this Kali Yuga, it is recommended that this Sankirtan Yoga should be performed. Then you will be happy. So what is the difficulty? In every village, the government has raised so much fund. Why not engage all the people to perform the Sankirtan Yoga? Every village, every house, every home, just perform the Sankirtan Yoga. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Simply sit down, all family members. Where is the difficulty? Husband, wife, children, friends, sit down together. There is no need of an instrument. Simply clap and chant Hare Krishna. Then you see the face of the world is changed. That is recommended. But we have no faith. We do not believe, although there is no expenditure, there is no loss. Still we shall not do. We shall make plan by raising fund. So after raising fund, what is done? We know everything. So that will not really. Take this yajna process. Yajnyan bhavati parjanna. If you are in scarcity of rain, perform yajna. The Sankirtan Yajna, there will be regular rain, and if there is regular rain, there is ample food production. There is no question of overpopulation. God can supply you more than you want, provided you become God conscious, Krishna conscious. That is the way. So we have to accept this. You don't be misled by the proposition of the so-called blind leaders that you are this body. The leaders are misguiding us by identification with this body. There is fight always. I am American, I am Indian, I am Russian, I am Pakistani, I am Hindustani, and there is fight. Advancement of civilization means advancement of fight. That's all. When there was no Pakistan, there was some sporadic Hindu-Muslim fight. Now there is a nation Pakistan and nation Hindustan, and there is organized fight every year. This is advancement. So don't follow this foolish advancement. Get to Krishna consciousness and be happy. This is not an ordinary movement. People are suffering actually for want of spiritual life, spiritual understanding. So the basic principle of spiritual understanding is to know oneself. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. To come to that point, Krishna is explaining that this body is like the dress. And the person who is dressed, that is within the dress. Dehinasmin jathadehi. Here also it is said, Tatha sarirani vihaya jirnani annani sangjati navani dehi. Very simple thing. There is no difficulty. But the so-called scientists, philosophers, educationists, they will not believe that there is soul. They will not believe. They will simply argue. They cannot establish the real fact how this body is moving. There are so many theories, but except they will not accept that they actually, because the soul is within this body, everything is happening. And without the soul, immediately this body, so nice body of such and such great personality, becomes a lump of matter. Not that the body is working, they are finding out the brain substance, how it is working. But the brain substance is already there in the dead body. Why don't you work with that? No, that is not fact. The fact is, the brain substance is a machine, but the man or the person is within the body. He is working with the brain substance. Just like you have got a nice machine, but it must be worked by somebody. In the present moment, a computer is a very certain machine, but this computer cannot work without an experienced mechanic who pushes the button and it works. These people, they cannot understand that without spiritual touch, matter cannot work. So brain may be combination of nice matter, but it cannot work without the spirit soul. Oh, we should clearly understand this. And if we accept this body as everything, just like the other day I told you, I met one big professor, Russian professor in Moscow. He said, Swamiji, after this body is finished, everything is finished. This is atheistic theory. This is not new. In India, there are many atheist followers of Charvaka. According to Charvaka Muni, his theory is, Vasibhutasya Dehasya Puna Kuta Puna Ragamana Bhave Rinam Kritya Ghitam Phide Javad Jive Sukham Jive Rinam Kritya Ghitam. Just live joyfully, merrily. No, I have no money. All I take, beg, borrow and steal. Somehow or other get money, and that is going on. Get money somehow or other and leave. That is Charvaka theory. Hedonism. Get money, that this is going, this civilization is going on. Somehow or other get money. Because without money you cannot get woman, you cannot get nice palatable food, nice dress, nice apartment, nice car. So bring money somehow or other. Everyone is coming forward as very philanthropist, leader. The aim is how to get money, that's all. That is their philanthropy. They speak so many nonsense things, but the real idea is how to get money. So this is going on. At the present moment, they are, after the sense gratification, they do not know that there is another life beyond Sankarsvi Krishna. They have known. That life is being taught in the Bhagavad Gita. That you are trying to advance your civilization for keeping this body fit. But you are not this body. Why you are wasting your time in that way? Jasyatma buddhi kunapeti dhatuke. Jasyatma buddhi kunapeti dhatuke. Anyone who is thinking that I am this body, sadhik kalatradishu, and sadhik means my men, my own kinsmen, who, my children, my family, my society, my country, kalatradishu, sadhik kalatradishu, boma ijadhi, and the land where these things have grown up, my body and my other relatives in relationship with this body, that is puja, sadhi, kalatradisu, bhoma, nationals. My country, I shall die for this land, I shall sacrifice everything. Sadhi, kalatradisu, bhoma, ijjadi, jatitha buddhi, salile. And those who are little advanced, pious, they go to places of pilgrimages, take a bath in the Ganges and come out. They think that water is Tirtha. No. Tirtha is saintly person, Tirtha Padam. You have to meet a saintly person to take lesson from them. The Tirtha Vaddhi Salilena Karihichi Janesu Avignesu. You have to meet self-realized persons. Those persons who do not care for this thing, and in the bodily concept of life, they have been described in this shastra, gokhara, cow and asses. So the Bhagavad Gita is the only book in the world which teaches to educate these cows and asses to human life. These mass of cows and asses have to be trained with these teachings of Bhagavad Gita. It is the beginning that Vasang Sitinnani Jathavihaya Navani Ginnati Naropuradi. This Vasang Siddhi, this body can be changed. Suppose now you are very much a great enemy of Pakistan. Take for example, I am not. All Pakistan is thinking, India, Hindustan is our great enemy. So what is this Hindustan and Pakistan or Russia? This is this body. Next life, you can take birth in Russia. Or you can take birth in, there is no certainty. Jangjana Bapi is, but according to Bhagavad Gita, you can understand, at the time of death, if you are going on thinking, oh, Pakistan is my enemy. Then you get a birth in Pakistan. Yes. Jangjang Bapis Swaran Bhava Tajatanti Kaliva. Because I shall get my next body according to my mental condition at the time of death. So, just like our women are taught to become very chaste. Why? There is a process to give her a chance to become a male next time. A woman, if she is educated to become chaste, attached to the husband, then naturally at the time of death she thinks of the man and she gets immediate. That is promotion. That is promotion. And similarly, if a man is very much attached to his wife, he'll think at the time of his wife he becomes a woman. These are the science. Where is this cultivation of this science? Simply all fools. And they are making research work. What is the research work? Can you go beyond the laws of the prakriti? It is not possible. Prakriti kiyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimuratma katta ham miti mannate ahankaram vimura. These rascals, they are under the full control of this material nature. and they are thinking we are independent. This is foolishness. So if you want to stop this foolish kind of civilization, animal civilization, of cows and asses, you have to teach Bhagavad Gita as it is. That is essential. That is the duty of every Indian. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu orders that. Bharat bhumite manushya janma hoyo. Anyone who has taken birth, he must be very pious, must have been very pious in his past life. Therefore he has got the chance. So, janma sarthakari. Janma sarthakari means make your life successful by taking advantage of so many Vedic literatures taught by the great saintly persons spoken by God Himself. You are not taking advantage of these facilities, natural facilities. You are misled by so-called material civilization and you are doomed. Andha jathan, vairupo niyama. If you are led by blind leaders, you are all doomed. That is going on. That is my appeal to the Indians. Don't be doomed. Accept Krishna as the leader. Then you'll be happy. As Krishna says, not only India, India special I say, because Krishna is so kind. Of course for Krishna, there is no such thing as Indian America. Just like the sun. The sun is neither Indian sun nor American sun. Sun is sun. But if you say, if you think that because now in India, the sun is visible, therefore Indian sun. That is your concoction. That is your mental concoction. Sun is neither Indian nor American. Similarly, God, Krishna, He is neither for Indian or for... He is for everyone. Sarvajonishu kauntya sambhavanti murtaya tasam mahajjani brahma aham bija padapit. He is the father of everyone. Not only human being, but the animals, the trees, the aquatics, everyone, all living entities. Mamai Mangsuji. This is universal. This is in this Krishna consciousness movement is therefore universal, real universe. So there are so many potencies out of this Krishna consciousness movement. Those who are intelligent. Krishna je bhaje sevaro chotu. Anyone who becomes Krishna conscious, he must be very, very intelligent. Otherwise one cannot become Krishna conscious. Krishna je bhaje sevaro chotu. So anyone who has taken to Krishna consciousness, he must be very intelligent man. Without being very intelligent man, one cannot take to Krishna consciousness. It is a Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Krishna je bhaje sevaro chotu, and Krishna himself says, Bahunam jalmanam ante jnanaman mang prabhadvat. After many, many births of struggling, if one actually becomes jnanaman, then he surrenders unto me. Vasudeva sarva meeti. Samahatma sudhindava. Om namo bhagavati vasudevaya. Janamadrasta jataha. These are the Vedic information. Vasudeva parayana. Vasudeva paramakha. These are the sati injunctions. So, a person can take intelligence from studying Bhagavad Gita. As Krishna says, the Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavan Mahang Prabuddha. After many, many births, because foolish rascals, they will have to transmigrate from one body to another. And there are 8,400,000 of different forms of body. And he has to go through the cycle of this birth and death. Bhutya bhutya praliyate. Take birth once and becomes, defy God, I don't care for God. And when Jamaraj comes, all right, whatever you like to do. Mittu sarva harasaham. These atheist class of men who defy the authority of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they will meet Krishna when? At the time of death. When Krishna is taking, take everything, his body, his society, his country, his family, his bank balance, his house, everything will be taken up. Mrityu sarva harashtaham. Mrityu, Krishna is appearing to the atheist class of man as sarva harasta. Sarva is taking everything. I am very much proud. Oh, I have got so much bank balance. I am the leader of this country. I am the father of so many children. I have got so beautiful wife. And so many things I am thinking, patta. I don't care for God. I am God. All right. At the time of death, are you God? Are you God at the time of death? God means control. Can you control your death? Then why have you God? God Ishara. Ishara means controller. Are you Ishara? Are you controller? Can you control birth? Can you control death? Can you control disease? Can you control old age? Then what kind of God you are? The foolish. Foolish person. Mura. They are called Mura. Abhajalanti mang Mura. The rascals only. They abhajalanti. Defy thee. So our, this Krishna consciousness movement is only to request him. It is your country's literature. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita. Krishna. Evil. Liberate. Janma karma me divvam jo janati tattvata takta dehang punar janma niti. Simply by understanding Krishna, you get liberation. Punar janma niti. The whole activities, human society's activities, should be targeted how to get rid of this repetition of birth and death. That is real civilization. Not that, let me live like a cat and dog and die like a cat and dog and never mind what is happening next. This is a civilization of ignorance. This is not a civilization of knowledge. Here is knowledge. That I am trying to protect my body, this dress. I am every day soaping my garment, but I am not taking any food. How long shall I live with this nice dress? The world should understand this verse very seriously. Vasam sitinnani jatha vihaya navali ginnati naro apurani. It has been especially mentioned naro. Naro means human being. The cats and dogs, they are changing their body, the same process, but they cannot understand. But here is specially mentioned naro. Human beings should understand this scientific knowledge that this body is just like a dress. It is changing. And we are changing just like according to price. We have a dress. If you go to a garment store, you can have nice dress if you pay more. And if you get less, you get a third class dress. Similarly, there are 8 million species or forms of life. Somebody is in the cat's body, somebody is in dog's body, somebody is in human being's body, somebody is in demigod's body. These bodies are offered by Prakriti according to price you pay. This is called karma. This is karma. If you perform good karma, then you get good body. Janma isajyasita sri. This is the janma. You get good birth. You get money. You get education. And you become beautiful by pious activities. And by impious activities, just the opposite. So either you get this or that. After all, it is birth and death. Stop the cycle of birth and death. Otherwise, it is animal civilization. Thank you very much.